Hey guys, Daniel here at SHOT Show 2018 for Gun Mag Warehouse. I'm here with Tom. We were at the range shooting this a couple days ago. Yes, you're good. I really dig the Tavor 7. I'd like the idea of it in a 308, but after Tom explained to me how it's so much different than their other Tavors, that's something we need to show you. So Tom, take it away, buddy.
All right, so some of the main features that are different from a standard X95 or a SAR, it's got a four-position gas regulator. So it's got regular, inverse, suppressed, and then off. You can turn it off completely. If you're running a subsonic 308, you don't want the bolt to cycle, yep, quieter, you can do that. It has M-lock as opposed to Picatinny rails. Normally we Picatinny'd everything up, you know, all over. Put it on if you want to. It slims it down when you don't need it.
Yep.
It still has the old hidden Picatinny rail underneath, though. We didn't want to change that. When you look at it, it's deceiving. It looks like a solid piece, but it's really not. The charging handle was one of the significant differences. So, as opposed to, you know, locking the bolt to the rear using the bolt catch, which is what we normally do, you pull it up, lift it in a notch, similar to an HK, and then you slap it down and do that. And it goes back into battery. To change the charging handle over from left to right, you literally only have to use a bullet tip or a punch, pull it back between these levers here, push a detent, pull it out, and then swap it over to the other side. It takes about 10, 15 seconds and you're done.
I know you're gonna get this, but we're just talking about converting it to from a right-handed person's gun to a left-handed, you know, making it ambi.
Yep.
You do this, no longer do you have to send this thing off or you have to buy extra thing or anything. The gun is super easy.
Super easy to work on. Let me get to the dust covers in
Go
a
ahead.
Second. We did a 45 degree pro as opposed to a 90. So the other leg won't interfere with your firing grip when you're actually going to engage a target. And then if you want to change the ejection port covers, all you do is, let me try and tighten it against me here. Lift, pull. That opens that side up. Turn around, lift, pull, rotate, that locks that piece in. Now I've switched the port itself without having to disassemble the gun.
That's a lot faster and cheaper.
Yeah. Well, also you gotta do the ejector, right, or the extractor. Yeah. All you have to do is pull the bolt out, remove the cam pin, rotate the bolt, put the cam pin back in, it reverses the cam pin. There's an L and an R on there to let you know which way the cam pin goes in. Put it back together, shove it back in, the whole gun's not converted over to left side.
That's awesome.
Yep.
That's cool.
The other kind of cool thing, a lot of folks see this and they think it's a solid cutlass. This is just like the X95. You don't want a cutlass, you can take an X95 pistol grip, use the one screw on the bottom, and put a standard pistol grip trigger guard on there if you prefer that. That's up to you.
That's awesome.
Yep.
Cool. So we're a little bit more set up for suppress with our adjustable gas.
Yep.
And you know, running different going subsonic and everything else.
Standard thread bit.
So much easier to change over from left-handed to right-handed, a lot easier than in the past. Still got the same trigger that you had in the later versions?
It's a different trigger insofar as the components are beefed up because the mass of everything inside it is more. So
right.
It's same trigger press though. It's about 6 pounds.
That's awesome.
And it uses SR25 like Magpul magazines. So great. You don't have to get it. We don't have a proprietary mag. There's nothing out there that's, you know, kind of weird. So.
SR25 mags, guys, if you pick up an IWI Tavor 7, you can get those mags at Gun Mag Warehouse. And thanks for watching. I'm Daniel Shaw. Thanks, Tom.
No worries.